Morning. Well, been here for about an hour or so now. Haven't seen any fish over the spot. Only put a little bit of bait in because I'm not sure how much has been cleaned up from last night. So I just sprinkled in half a handful of chops. All three baits are out on the spot there. So the right hand rod is near the bush there, on the edge of the spot. The middle rod is right in the middle of the spot, and the left hand rod is in the chod, right at the left hand extreme of the spot. And there's nothing about at the moment. It sure does look nice today. A light northerly blowing in. The sun's up and the sky is blue with some cloud. It's a lovely September day and I am really pleased to be here. And if we catch anything like we did yesterday, we're in for a treat.
Well, you might have noticed a change in approach by me, i.e. not moving around, sitting still in the same swim. And there's a good reason for that. The spot's going at the moment, as far as I can tell. Certainly I've noticed that the fish come in here between about 11 and 3 every day. All the fish seem to get in here at some point. So there's a good chance that I'll get all the fish. Well, there's a good chance that I'm going to hook a number of fish out of this swim. So I've elected to stay put, wait for the fish to come to me. I found, obviously, that it's better to be there waiting for them rather than chase them around and chuck a lead at them. Certainly the other day when I found them on the bar, I chucked a lead and that spooked them right out. So being here early and getting the leads in before they get here is a handy thing to do because, obviously, they're not so spooked. So, yeah. Well,
I suppose really all we've got to do now is wait. So I think I'll make another cup of coffee. Read my new scientist. What have we got in there? Oh, yum. I think I'll have that.
I've got my frying pan today, but remember my glasses.
And there you go. Come on, give me a run.
Well, I've just spotted my first fish on. If you can hear that. Probably sounds like a high-pitched car horn, but for a second there I thought my pot alarm was going off and I was looking at the rod and nothing was happening. I've just spotted a fish on the spot. It's the first sighting this morning. It's about 12 o'clock, so that's about the right time. They normally, they have been getting here for the last week or so, around that time of the day. So, yeah, the old blood pressure goes up a little bit. And the feeling of excitement starts to flow. And yesterday I had the first fish at about 1:30, I think the other one at about 3:30. I think last week I had runs at around 1:30, 2:30, 3-ish. So yeah, we're sort of entering the time now, and hopefully we'll catch a fish. I have to say, I really want to catch one of the 30s out here too, one of the commons. That would be pucker. I came close yesterday. Yeah. That was a big fish. Tiny little head on it, but big fish. So yeah, we've had no problems getting any of the fish out of here really, apart from the ones we've lost, so there you go. Well, I'm going to pop up the tree and have a look, see if there's anything in the swim. And if not, then I'm going to nip round and have a look, see if I can't see what the bait situation on the bottom of the lake's like. But, you know, I just had a thought. Could do with an underwater camera here. Maybe next year I might be able to afford to get one of those. That'd certainly be good. And there doesn't appear to be anything over the spot. Let's have a quick look at the spot, if you can. The sun's gone in, so it's not going to be easy. There's nothing on it at the moment. And I can't see how much bait is out there either, because it's too windy. And then the sunshine. Well, there's some nice big dark shapes appearing over the patch. I've just got down from the tree quickly and they're definitely feeding as well, so cross your fingers. Well, there's still fish appearing over the spot. Yeah, I really want to catch them, obviously, but I just want to crack on, because I know that if I can really start to get to grips with these fish and start catching a few, there's a real good chance that I'll get one of the biggies amongst them. But when it's like just the odd fish here and there, then that's when, you know, struggle. So I don't want to struggle anymore. I want to catch these bloody fish. I want to crack on and get them. The sun's not doing me any favours. That yellow spot's lit up like a firework. obviously I've done as much camouflaging as I think is necessary, but I'm quite happy to weed up my rigs if need be or whatever. I think that might be necessary actually. Certainly going by the fact the amount of fish that come into the swim. About 15 minutes ago I had a bip 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 bip, which as far as I'm concerned is a pickup. So yeah, there's room for improvement. I just wait for one of those to go flying off, but hopefully it will. Well, I've just been done again, this time on the left hand rod. It went up beep 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 and then went beep 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 beep. So yeah, tests in the garden indicate that that definitely was probably a bite. Definitely, probably. Yeah, no, I've been done over there, definitely. So, yeah, I've been up the tree and there's fish still in the swim, and it's the time when they do get in this area, between sort of 12:30 and 4 o'clock, something like that. So, yeah, but they're doing me over, they're getting away with it. Bummer. I'm gonna have to work on that. Well, I've done it. There you go. I'm gonna reweigh the weighing sling, but that's on 30. There you go. There it is. That's the one I've been waiting for. There you go. In there. Let's get it sorted. Well, would you believe it? I've only got 1 minute left on my videotape. So, there you go. That's my first 30 out of the Woolpack. 5 years it's taken me to get this fish. 5 long years, and I've got 1 minute of video left. I'm going to take a few pictures. There's a lad here to help me. So there you go. And Reservoir Dogs, you owe me a pair of waterproof Speedos, mate. You saw the weight of this, didn't you, mate?
Yep.
So there you go. Time's running out. So there's my first 30. Well broad, and it really does weigh. It really does weigh. Can't tell you how pleased I am with this fish. All my hard work in 5 years.
You earned it.
Means a lot to me. It means a lot to me.
Beep beep.
Yeah, so let's get some pictures of this baby.
I mean, it's a long time, isn't it, when you're waiting?
Yeah. She's beautiful. There you go, let's get some quick pictures. All my hard work in 5 years.
You earned it.
Means a lot to me. It means a lot to me.
Beep beep.
Yeah, so let's get some pictures of this baby.
I mean, it's a long time, isn't it, when you're waiting?
Yeah. She's beautiful.